Hey everybody, welcome to another amazing episode of...
I don't know who you are. I don't know what you want. If you're looking for ransom, I can tell you I don't have money.
Is that the... Nah, okay. So anyway...
But what I do have are a very particular set of skills. Skills that I've acquired over a very long career. Skills that make me a nightmare for geeks like you.
All right, first off, I knew Toy Story was real. Like, I knew it. Second off, How can you possibly have a set of skills? You're only a 6-inch toy, and you can't really get out of your box.
If you let me out now, that'll be the end of it. I will not look for you.
We're right here.
I will not pursue you.
Again, you're stuck in the box.
But if you don't, I will look for you.
Still, right here.
I will find you.
Probably because we're right in front of you.
And I will kill you.
Oh, easy there, bud, easy. First of all, you're supposed to be Liam Neeson in Star Wars, not Liam Neeson in Taken. And second of all, we were going to let you out anyway.
Yeah.
We're the unbox boys. We unbox toys. We let them out.
Yeah.
Oh. Well, this is embarrassing. If I had my other hand attached, I'd do a Jedi mind trick on you and make you forget this whole thing.
Okay, now that we've got all that straightened out, a couple of weeks ago, we let you guys decide which figure for us to review, and Yoda came in first, but Qui-Gon Jinn from the Star Wars Black Series was a close second, so we're finally getting to that. Let's check out the box really quick. Star Wars Black Series, Qui-Gon Jinn with the nice artwork there. We've got the figure, a lightsaber, and an extra hand where he kind of does the whole force, forget about it, this never happened thing. On this side, he is number 40 in the series. On the back, if you want to read that information, you can do that at your leisure. And then on this side, we've got the Qui-Gon Jinn name with that kind of cool shadow background. Let's crack it open and check out the slap! And there he is, the gray Jedi, Qui-Gon Jinn.
Yeah, now, one of the most more popular gray Jedis.
Now, what is a gray Jedi? Because you just told me off camera, because I didn't know what it was.
Well, a gray Jedi is, I don't know if it's really canon or not, but that's what people call the Jedis...
that are old.
No.
Gray
Jedi. No. Not like you. But you would be a gray Jedi if that was
the
case.
I would be a great Jedi. Great, you forgot the T. The great Jedi.
No. All right. No. Just kidding.
How great can he be? He fell over. He is a gray Jedi.
Well, a gray Jedi basically is...
doesn't fall over.
A Jedi that kind of goes and bends the rules a little bit, or doesn't follow all of the rules, or, you know, the Jedi Council usually wants to stay by the book, but people like Qui-Gon Jinn, who sometimes they break the rules, like in A Phantom Menace,
right.
The only movie with him in it,
yeah,
he does, and he's doing stuff like that. He breaks the rules and does something with Anakin, and he trains him or something like that when they didn't want him to. Something like that.
Okay.
But,
so I'm a Jedi.
So he's a gray Jedi.
I follow the rules.
Yeah.
Until I don't want to. And then...
yeah.
Okay.
That's... yeah. Okay. So he's a pretty cool guy. Another gray Jedi is, like, Ahsoka Tano is considered a gray Jedi because she went away from the Jedi Order and sometimes didn't follow the rules all the way. Also, okay. And other people are like the one guy with the yellow stripe on his nose, like
I don't know that guy.
He, like, he's cool, but I forget his name. So
put in the comments below if you know. Yeah. I'm thinking of Darth Maul's brother, but that's not who you're talking about.
No, that's
Savage.
Savage Opress.
He's the only one I think of with yellow, but there's another.
No, he's a humanoid-ish character.
Okay.
He's like the main gray Jedi. Like, he totally breaks the rules and bends with the dark side sometimes is what the gray Jedis are. Like, they use some of the dark side and get in the light side. Also, in non-canon lore, there is, I think it was Leia and Han's son that, like, was a Jedi, but then he kind of is using the dark side somewhat too. But or it could so be Luke's Kylo, child. So I not don't Kylo remember. Ren
we're talking about in the
no in the non-canon, okay. like right. in the legacy
okay.
area.
Because Kylo Ren is definitely leaning more toward yeah. the dark than the gray.
Yeah.
All right, let's check out the figure here of Qui-Gon Jinn. First, in our slap scale, we take a look at the sculpt. As far as the sculpt goes on this figure, I'd say it looks pretty good. I think they've got some nice detail in the face, some really subtle kind of forehead lines, just barely there, but you can kind of see him. Mm-hmm. A furrowed brow. I think the beard is sculpted in nicely, and the mustache, just kind of the lips in general. The hair looks good, too. They've got this kind of ponytail work going on in the background here. Although, one thing I did notice, if you look real close, right in there, there's a small gap. Let me get a little closer here if I can. Small gap between the top hairpiece and the bottom hairpiece. You see that little skin there? I'm not sure if that's just the figure that we got or if they're all kind of like that, but it's kind of a Qui-Gon comb-over toupee thing going on there. So kind of just be aware of that. Look for it on yours. Maybe it's, again, just the figure I've got here. As far as the rest of the body goes, though, I'd say it looks pretty good. The robes are sculpted nicely with lots of nice wrinkles and folds, the pants, and in particular, even the little details here on the boots where it kind of has all these little holes in it. Just pretty good. So for sculpts, we'll give that a full point.
Full point.
As far as likeness goes, what do you think?
I think it looks like Liam Neeson. Well, let me see. I don't know. It looks like him. I think you could tell it was Qui-Gon Jinn since the outfit and all, but there's some random guy with a different outfit and that ponytail. I wouldn't know.
Yeah. The face itself, I mean, it's not Hot Toys level, dead on likeness of Liam Neeson. But I'd say for this $20 price range for Black Series, I think they did a pretty good job, actually. Yeah. And with the hair and the ponytail, there's no mistaking that's Qui-Gon Jinn. So we'll be generous on this one. Give it a full point.
Full point.
As far as articulation goes, if you want a cool hairdo, you're going to pay the price for articulation because he does not go very far. That's about it, side to side. He can't really look up because the ponytail, he can look down a little bit, though, which is pretty cool. As far as the shoulder goes, this is kind of your standard Black Series stuff. The elbow joint is actually nice and long, so you can actually get some pretty good movement at the elbow there and even hold the lightsaber with both hands, as you already saw. The wrists have a twist. No ab crunch, but it does have a twist. As far as the legs go, pretty good split. It does have an upper thigh cut, which gives you a twist there. Double jointed at the knee, and the foot has that rocker and joint as well. So for articulation, apart from the head not moving around too much, we'll give that a pass and give it a full point.
Full point.
All right, and as far as the paint, what do you think?
I think it's pretty good. I like the different shades in the cloth kind of right there, the darker in the middle and then lighter on the outsides.
Nice gradients.
Yes, and they really defined the belt, like different shades on different parts of the belt. Mm-hmm. Even in the browns, there's different. And over here, it looks a little bit sloppy, I think, with the gray things. I don't know what those are, but all in all, it looks really good.
Yeah, maybe a little glopped on there. Mm-hmm. A little bit. But yeah, as far as some of these tiny little buttons and things, I think they did a really good job. That can't be easy to nail it on.
Yeah. It looks pretty good.
Yeah.
A figure.
I think they maybe could have done a little more. We've seen some figures with a really nice skin tone and whatnot. This seems to be kind of just one flat color and not really that nice kind of soft. I don't know. It's not bad, I guess. The eyes are going in mostly the same direction.
You can't even really see them from
they're pretty dark.
My point of view.
Yeah, but so it's not too bad. The hair does have some highlights in it, which adds, you know, a little bit. As you mentioned, the gradient. As far as the pants, you're pretty much dealing with single colors here. So all in all, I think they probably could have done a little bit better. But the belt, I think, really kind of shows off some nice detail work. So I don't know. What do you think? Half point, full point?
I think it's, I don't know, probably.
Your call, man.
Half point. I'm not very giving.
Half point.
Half point.
All right, so here's the lightsaber. It's really cool. This is one of my favorite lightsabers, actually, in all of Star Wars era stuff. I don't know really why. I think it was because I used to have a toy of this, but
sentimental value.
Yeah, sentimental value. But it looks really good. They did a good job on the paint job. And I like the color of the blade. They did a good job on the translucent kind of dealio, if that's the right wording.
Sure.
But another cool thing is on the figure. Well, this can pop off. The blade can pop off from the thing. So on Qui-Gon Jinn, I noticed that there's a little hole. So
yeah, I was wondering what that hole is for, because usually they have a little hook if you want to hook on the lightsaber, but he doesn't have that.
You can put in the lightsaber, I'm assuming. That's what that's for. Yeah, it is.
You know, that's kind of cooler. That's a lot cooler, actually, than the little hook they've got that kind of sticks out and those swing around a little bit.
Oh, yeah.
That's cool. I like that.
Cool.
Bonus points.
Bonus points.
So this 6-inch Star Wars Black Series figure of Qui-Gon Jinn gets a 3.5 out of 4 on the slap scale.
With some bonus points.
I don't know who you are, but you will click the thumbs up button. You will subscribe to this channel. And click the notification bell icon. And you will leave a nice comment in the comment section. Or I will kill you.
Thanks so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. If so, be sure to slap that thumbs up and share it with your friends. Click our circular logo in the top left to subscribe to our channel. It's absolutely free. And there's a link to another video you might like in the bottom left. If you want to reach out to us, comment or check out our info in the description below. And above all, remember, God loves you. It's the truth. And Jesus is the proof.
Peon Box Boys.